Hey, what's going on you guys? It's Acid Glow here. Now we have a breakdown video for Tenchu Z. Now we'll be going over all of the unlockable skills you can get for your ninja character from level 1 to level 3. Now keep in mind in the menu where it shows the required abilities, that means you need a certain amount of points adjusted to that attribute before you can use specific ninja skills. So let's get started here. Now the first one on the list is Repel. So this allows you to repel incoming shuriken that are thrown at you from the enemy. Now the enemy will only really throw a shuriken at you if you're on a higher altitude when they are aware of your presence. The problem with this ability is when the enemy is aware of your presence, the main thing you want to do is get out of sight. You don't want to stay within their sight for them to throw projectiles. So I really don't think this is one ability you'd want to use. It's really kind of useless because, I mean, why would you want to stay there and give them the opportunity to throw shurikens just so you can repel them when it's better just to get out of sight? Now we're going to look at Stagger. So this is a parry format before the enemy is about to hit you. Now what happens if you do this correctly is you would go into a block animation and you'd see like this blue spark appear. And what the purpose of this is aside from just being a parry, it pushes you away from the opponent if you block at the correct frame before the attack is going to hit you. Now the benefit to this one is it'll push you away from the opponent so you'll have more distance after the block or the parry so you have enough time to run away. So it's somewhat okay if you like to use parrying. So we're going to have a look at this in action. So right here, this is a normal blocking animation. So as you see, when the enemy hits me and I'm blocking, I don't really get much distance after I block their attack. So we're going to have a look at a parry style and I'll show you the difference in the distance. See, this is the parry distance. As you see, you'll see a very quick blue flash of a spark and you'll get a certain amount of range within the distance of the block so you can run away a little bit safely. So now we're looking at Shadow. So this is performed the same way as the parry, holding left trigger and X right before the enemy's attack is about to hit your character. If done correctly, you would disappear in a puff of smoke and appear behind the enemy, and you would have a huge amount of distance between yourself and the enemy. So from there, you can choose if you want to continue to fight or if you want to run away. So I'll show you guys what it looks like in video so you can get a better understanding. Now, it's supposed to teleport you behind the enemy, but if the opponent is putting his back to a wall, then you won't go directly behind him. But in some cases, you'll actually go directly behind him. So now we're looking at the three set of skills you can use by pulling out your sword, holding the X button for a few seconds, and then releasing. So the first one on the list is Shock. And I've got to say, this is the worst one. This is one you do not want to invest in if you're just starting off in the game. It's really bad, really, really bad. So in the first video, I'm going to show you guys just what it looks like so you can get an idea, you know, just what it looks like in action on an enemy. So I've knocked down an enemy. He's actually dizzied, so he can't fight back. So you pull out your sword and then you charge it up to three levels. And then when you release it, it does like this single overhead smash with the sword and then that's it. You know, so the enemy has like this purplish or bluish kind of effect as they're on fire or something. Now, the problem with this one is as you're charging, it takes too long to charge to level 3, okay? You're also vulnerable because you move very slow. And the initial attack to come out to hit the opponent is really slow. And a lot of times it can miss just like that. So it's really one that is not worth investing in if you're just starting off the game for the first time. So, I mean, this was one I had high hopes for until I finally tried it out. And then I realized this is really bad. This is not a good one. Now the next one on the list is the drop. So this is basically a grab attack. So this is actually the famous Izuna drop that we have seen in other ninja games where you grab the opponent, you fly into the air and you come down vertically and smash the opponent's head onto the ground and then your character bounces off them. Now you have a choice to use this as a finishing move for a stealth attack. And you can even use it as a move in standard combat. For those of you that like to do sword fights in Tenchu games, you can even use it in that purpose as well, as I'll show you right here. So there we go. The Izuna drop is actually my favorite in this category. So now we're looking at Gale. So this is basically a dashing attack that allows you to do multiple dashes and slashes, providing you push the X button at the correct timing after the first initial slash. So you cannot mash the X button and get this powerful attack. So you've got to learn to perfectly time the X button after the first slash hits, you push X. After the second one hits, you push X. The timing is a little strict, but with enough practice, it becomes a very powerful move to even dispatch multiple enemies with a single move. So now we're looking at a different category. So these ones are activated by pulling out your sword, holding the right bumper, and then pushing the left stick down. So we're looking at armor right now. So it basically increases your defense for about 10 real-time seconds. The problem with this ability is the fact that 10 seconds is not long enough. The time to activate, like going through the whole animation, takes way too long for me. Now, if you're gonna try to do this from a safe distance from the enemy, the problem here is you're gonna spend a few seconds running back to the combat scene, and then by then it's gonna wear off, so it's really one I will never use myself. So the next one is power. So it's basically the opposite of defense. It's activated the same way, but there's a very big drawback. You will get a damage boost to your attacks, but at the same time, you're gonna take more damage from the enemy. So, you know, when you kind of put that together with the very slow time and the activation, it's just really not that good at all. So unless you just wanna play around with these two abilities, they're ones I recommend you do not use at all. And this one is Badger. This is the best one out of the three, in my opinion. This one allows you to dash from a huge amount of distance very fast. Now, you will make a little bit more noise as you're dashing, but if you do it from a very long range, enemies will not even know you're coming for them. It's a great way to kind of advance on an enemy from a long range and grab them or go straight into a stealth kill animation. On top of that, you can use this special skill to escape enemy battles if you need to quickly get out of a situation. So now we're going on to another category. These ones are performed by pushing left trigger, right bumper, and X at the same time. The first one is Rice. When you have this on level 3, it allows you to create up to 5 rice balls in one level. So if you don't want to use any healing items or purchase healing items, this is one you can use to heal yourself with your own ability. You can also use this to heal any teammates you're playing in co-op with. Now this one is Voice. So it's a really good one and I've used it a couple of times. So you can use it in ways like luring an enemy to your location and then running off. So while they're going to your location, you can sneak to where they currently were before. So in other ways, you can use it for a teammate that can go behind them and then execute them. Or if you're playing solo, you can lure them to a place where you have the advantage and then jump down and then stealth kill multiple enemies within a second. Now this one is Ears, and it's a form of radar to some extent. So it allows you to detect moving enemies only. So if there are enemies that are standing still and never moving from their location, it's not going to pick them up on your little radar. So a good way to use this is especially from long range distances or around corners or before you enter a room, because sometimes you're just not sure if there's 1, 2, or 3 enemies in a room. So this could give you some idea if there's more than one that's currently moving in that vicinity. So it is a pretty good one. So now we're moving on to the ultimate arts category. The first one is Recover. It's done by pushing left trigger and X after you've been knocked over. So as you're getting up, you have faster recovery so you don't get hit as you're getting up. But to be honest, I've never really needed this one because I've just blocked or rolled out of the way as I was getting up. Now this one is Wall, and it's actually pretty neat. Now when you jump toward a wall, you hold the right bumper button to actually hold onto the wall. And from there you can actually choose to jump to the opposite wall if it's within range and then use it to scale the wall to get to the roof. Or if you want, you can use it as a means to run across the wall, jump to the other side and hold, and then run again. So you can use it in two different ways. Now this one here is eyes. So it basically allows you to zoom in from very long ranges so you can see what enemies and how many of them lurk ahead of wherever you're actually going to travel. So you can get a good idea if you should change your gameplay on advancing through the roof or through the side of the houses or in the shadows and so on. And this one here is ceiling. It's actually one of my favorites because it allows you to stick to the ceiling and stay on there for a very long amount of time. And you still have the ability to look around and move slowly as you're holding on to the ceiling. You also have access to a stealth kill that is only done by holding on to the ceiling, which is pretty cool. Now, there's two ways you can hold on to the ceiling. The first one is by using the grappling hook and clinging onto a ceiling, and then you hold the right bumper button as you reach up there, and you'll basically just cling on there. The other way is by going near a ledge from a rooftop, falling down, or if you want, just using a grappling hook and hooking yourself onto the ledge. So as you're holding onto a ledge, just hold the right bumper button and your character will eventually just latch under and hold onto the ceiling. And from there you have the same options to look around, move slowly, and do that cool stealth kill from the ceiling. Now we're going to look at conceal. Now in order to use this one, your sword must be in your sheath, so you have to be barehanded. So you put yourself to the wall and then you push left stick, and then you hold left trigger and then you push X. And your ninja will actually pull out this invisible blanket in front of him. So it's only going to cover your visibility from your front, and the enemies can still see you from the left and right sides. So those areas are still exposed. The overall effect is neat, but knowing that you're still exposed from the left and right side doesn't really make it too usable, especially when you can simply just use a badger and just get out of sight and get into cover much faster. Now here's a couple that don't really need too much video footage to explain. Now this one is jump. So supposedly it adds invincibility to your little hops and jumps. I didn't really need to use that in combat too much, so it's not one I really use. Now the next one we're going to look at is energy. So it basically increases your defense automatically. So if you're looking to kind of get a boost in defense but you don't want to use the actual ability that we showed earlier, this is one you can look at and just kind of be all right with. After this one we have venom. This one is completely useless because I've never been poisoned by an enemy after playing this game multiple times in the story mode. There simply is no enemy that I've seen that will poison me, or if there is, there aren't enough of them. So this is one you never really need to use at all. So when it comes to venom, just forget it. This one here is blade. So it increases the attack damage on your sword swing moves and also on your secret arts. So this one here is boom. So it increases the blast radius on explosive equipment. Now, I've never really used explosive equipment at all during my playthroughs or co-op sessions. This is more of something you can use just to play around with for fun, because I've never found any situation where the enemies are always bundled up together close enough to all get hit by one explosive. Now, you can use this in combination with lure for some very funny effects, but I don't think it's an art you're going to need for playing story mode or for some co-op sessions. Now this one here is shuriken. Now it allows you to instantly kill an enemy with a headshot if you use a shuriken. Now you're limited to how many shurikens you can carry per level, so you won't be using them all the time. And at the same time, your shuriken are limited by range, so you won't be able to use it from super long ranges. So if you just want to have some fun, this is probably one you can use, but its overall effectiveness, I don't think it's something you're going to be using a lot in story mode or online. It just doesn't really seem like it's quick enough or that useful enough, really. But here we go. See, I'll show you. I tried to use it from a very long range and it just did not work. So there you go. That's shuriken. Now the next two ones I'm going to show you are some of the best ones in the game. The first one is lurk. So this one reduces the enemy's visibility, so it makes it harder for them to see you from certain ranges. Combine this while you're crouching and you're almost invisible to them from close ranges to medium ranges. The next one is feet. This one reduces the amount of sound you produce from running. So if you have both these on, it makes it really great for sneaking upon enemies to grab them, to stealth kill, or simply to run by enemies unnoticed. Now I'll show you an example of how feet works. Right here, I don't have it on, so I'm running by this little path here, and you can see in the bottom left corner, I still produce a lot of sound. The enemy cannot see me, but he heard something nearby. We're gonna run the same path again with feet activated. So as you see in the bottom left corner, I'm not producing any sound as I run right by the enemy. And the last art you have here is sense. So this one allows you to detect the enemy's health just by holding the right trigger. It activates around maybe 2 seconds after holding right trigger. So it's not one I really used a lot of, only in very rare situations, but it's not one I rely on. Now, the last thing I want to go over is something called the total stealth kill. Now, in the options under display, you will see something called Ninja Seal. If you have that set to on, then you will see these symbols across your character if you're holding an enemy or close enough to do a stealth kill. The purpose of this is to get more points during a stealth kill if you do it when the symbols are red. Also, if you have this option off, if you're a headset user, you will hear a heartbeat sound during the initial time the red text is supposed to appear. So those are two ways you can actually get more points when you're doing stealth kills. Well guys, this is the end of the video for the breakdown on the Tenchu Z Ninja Arts. I want to thank you guys very much for watching, and please leave a thumbs up on the video. I will appreciate it. This is Acid Glow, and I will see you guys in the next video. I'm out.